Shavua Tov, everyone, and Shana Tova. Have a great week and a great new Jewish year, 5785. Welcome to Tillis Tells Stories for Saturday Night. The title of this week's video is Empty of Beauty, Full of Joy. I copy-edited and supplemented it from the Sukkot section of kollive.com, where it was picked up and shared internationally on social media. 1 year before Sukkot, the Chassid Rabbi Elia Gross asked Rabbi Yehuda Klapman of Crown Heights, Yehuda Klapman is a well-known sofer, a scribe in Crown Heights, Brooklyn, if he had already bought a lulav. When he replied, not yet, Gross suggested that he go to the house of a certain individual to purchase an esrog from him, because this Jew needs very much the income. Chapman obliged and went there and looked around in his stock for a nice esrog. However, he couldn't find a single specimen that pleased him. After he'd already been searching for some time, another man came in, someone he was acquainted with. He picked an esrog quickly, asked how much it cost, paid, and turned to leave. But Klapman followed the man to the door. As they exited the house, he caught up with him and asked, what nice esrog were you able to find here? I looked for a good while, but I couldn't find anything of reasonable quality. The answer impressed him, to say the least. For me, the other replied, a mehudar esrog, an extra beautiful esrog, is one bought to provide needed income to help a Jew with all his sukkot expenses, referring, of course, to the seller of the esrogin. On Yom Tov, outside of Israel, the first 2 days of the festival, Klapman saw the man again in shul. Out of curiosity, he decided to check what esrog he was really using. He figured that since the man had the means to do so, for sure he bought himself a beauty of an esrog elsewhere, and the other esrog was a spare, that is the one he had seen him buy, offering others to bless upon, bought just to support that merchant for Sukkot, but not for his mitzvah use. When he saw what esrog the man used to bless upon and for the shakings, Klapman was astonished. The man actually used that somewhat inferior esrog that he had seen him buy. He was so touched by what he witnessed that he considered writing to the Rebbe this beautiful story of pure Ahav Israel, love for a fellow Jew, and chesed, kindness. He went to the Rebbe's office and hesitatingly asked the secretary on duty if it would be appropriate to write this story to the Rebbe. This man, like the several other Hasidim of the Lubavitcher Rebbe's secretariat, worked closely with the Rebbe on a daily basis and was not pleased with the question. He responded, every day, the Rebbe gets letters full of negativity and sadness. And here you have a beautiful story of pure love for a fellow Jew that would give the Rebbe so much pleasure, and you are hesitating to write? Klapman got the message. He exited the office and went to a certain Jew in Crown Heights who has a beautiful handwriting, as well as being a masterful writer. I told him the story, and he went ahead to write for the Rebbe the whole Megillah, meaning a long and detailed recitation based on the idea of Megillat Esther, the scroll of Esther. That's the idea of the Megillah, a rolled scroll. He wrote it telling the story in poetic Yiddish and with charm. He used special paper, and he wrote it with gorgeous calligraphy, lettering, and style. As soon as he finished, I hurried back to the office to hand the letter in for it to be delivered to the Rebbe. Next day, the Rebbe's secretary phoned me. He said, I have no answer from the Rebbe for you, but I can describe to you what happened with your letter. I put your letter on top of the pile of letters I brought into the Rebbe. I wanted your letter to be the first letter the Rebbe saw, so that he would likely read it first. Sure enough, the Rebbe took your letter from the top of the pile and began reading. I stayed by the door and watched, and this is what I saw. The Rebbe started reading, and right away I noticed he was not reading fast, as he usually did. I saw that he was concentrating, reading your letter word by word and line by line. And with each line, I saw the Rebbe's smile grow bigger and bigger and bigger. Your letter gave the Rebbe tremendous nachas, pleasure, and joy. And we, friends, should give the Creator also much nachas through our beautiful Sukkot observance and secure Sukkot. Hag Sameach and Shabbat Shalom.